In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. My brothers and sisters, we welcome the remarkable remains of Nora to the church here today. So on behalf of all gathered in the parish of as large as well, we extend our sympathies to all the family and to the near relatives. We begin now with the invitation to prayer at the beginning. My brothers and sisters, we believe that all the ties of friendship and affection which Jesus has won throughout our lives do not unravel with death. Confident that God always remembers the good we have done and forgives our sins, let us pray asking God to gather Nora to himself. Lord, in our grief we turn to you. Are you not the God of love, hope, dearest to all? Listen to our prayers for your servant, whom you have called into this world. Lead her to your kingdom of light and peace, and count her with the saints in glory, and bless this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now we're just about to start Mass. And are you having something for the opening hymn? Even play the same tune again. Even it's lovely. It's a lovely show. So just sit down for a moment, just listen to a beautiful piece of music. Again, for the beginning of Mass, as we are gathered to offer the soul of Nora to Almighty God, asking in this Mass that you be cleansed of our human imperfections, and that you be accounted with the saints in glory, and that our friend who is grieving at this particular time will be consoled, knowing that she lived a great and long life, a gift given to her that not many people have, to live to her grand old age. And today, now that she is reunited with her own people, those who went before her own parents and all the other relations, that she saw go depart from this life over the decades. And now the group again will play the same little tune again we had a moment ago, as a remarkable remains were brought into the church. And it is part of our glory and our praise of Almighty God today. The gift can be put under the table there for a second.
Linda, I can sacrifice my culture to symbolize Nana's love for all of her family. He was of an apron and a pot of jam to symbolize Nana's love for cooking and baking. And he brings up wheels of thread to symbolize Nana's love for repairing and creating garments. Rachel brings up a cattle ornament to symbolize Nana's love for all animals. And TJ brings up a pack of cards to symbolize Nana's love for a game of 41.
Thanks. Now let us join with us. Let us make the silent fasting together as we begin our Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. At the start of Mass, we want to remind ourselves of our own human frailty and our weaknesses, and we ask for God's pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Nora, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us sit now for the scriptures. So we'll do the reading there and come to the microphone there.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven. A time for giving birth and a time for dying. A time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted. A time for healing, a time for knocking down and a time for building. There is a time for tears and a time for laughter. A time for mourning and a time for dancing. A time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up. A time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing. A time for searching and a time for losing. A time for keeping, a time for throwing away. A time for tearing and a time for sowing. A time for keeping silent and a time for speaking. A time for loving and a time for peace. This is the word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds, together with them, to meet the Lord in the air. So we should stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Let us all now stand to read the gospel. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The will of my Father, says the Lord, is that I should lose nothing of what is given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. Hallelujah. The Lord be with you. It's a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowd, all that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I shall not turn him away. Because I have come from heaven not to do my own will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. Now the will of him who sent me is that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I shall raise it up on the last day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Just sit for a moment, please. We have, my brothers and sisters, we'll reflect for a moment or so. We've got two great books. And both books reflect in one way or another the face of God to us. The first great book that we're all very aware of and know about and yeah, have heard about is the Bible itself. It reveals to us so much of God's face, his love for the human family, his promises to us, what's to become of us, and also a book that reveals ourselves to ourselves, so to speak. It reveals so much of human nature, who we are, what we're about. The other great book is the book of nature. In one way or another, it both reveals and at the same time conceals the face of God. It does both. Some people can look at nature and never see anything of God in it. Others can look upon nature and see so much of God. And the human family, we're part of nature, the book of nature. We're within creation itself, so we're part of the book of nature, the human family. But if we want to rather just deconstruct the human family is just a lump, a group, we think instead of individuals. And the individual within the human family is where often we encounter something of God himself in the face of God. So in a sense, the person sitting next to you on the seat this morning, each one of them is a Bible to you. Because one way or another, people around you there will reveal something of God to you as individuals, just like the book of the scriptures. So therefore there's something profound about every human being, and also something that you can't quite measure with any human standards. It escapes our full understanding and the mystery that each person is. Now for Nora's family this morning, I said to you, she lived a grand old age, and if you're honest with yourself, you see, you saw something of God reflected in her. And is captured by the next number of days now, the weeks to come. If you say to yourself, what did Nora give me in life? As a member of family and for neighbors, what did she reflect of God to me? The asking question is, what wisdom has she left you with? The wisdom that she gave by her very life is part of you. Perhaps you might be familiar well at the moment. But the day might come and say, yeah, I learned that from Nora. She gave me something. She gave me something profound that I cannot, you know, say, I cannot purchase or buy. Her wisdom and the other aspects of her being that were reflected God. And you also ask yourself, what gifts have Nora that led her to live a long, long life? And if these gifts there, have you yourself got any of them? Or some of these gifts part of your makeup? And if they are you nourishing them the way she nourished them? The gifts that she had, are you making them your own, that she has given to you? And you can ask all these profound questions of her and what we've inherited from others. And often, you know, when people depart this life, people look back and say, yes, there was so much about her that was good. So much about no human being is perfect, only for instance that in the Mother Mary. The rest is so flawed in one way or another. But if you look to the core, the goodness of a person's life, they have given you something that you couldn't get anywhere else. You wouldn't get it in school, you wouldn't get it from others, you wouldn't get it from work colleagues. But there might be something in her that touched your heart and your life that you are deeply appreciative of her. Another question I could put before you this morning is, if each of one individual notebook handed, but if each one of you will ask for a moment, what would you write on Nora's headstone? What would you put down? To help to focus your mind very quickly, What exactly was it about her that made you tick and that you feel was a great gift and made an impact upon you and in your world? Now, don't fall into the trap of the, what is the British, who she claimed he was Irish, Spike Milligan, author, comedian, rogue, eccentric. And many years ago, when he died, he had his heart, he had made out already what he was going to put his own headstone. And so we may know this already, but on his headstone the words are, "Didn't I tell you I was sick?" That was the number that passed by his grave, and so on. If I had been, didn't know what he was dead, he'd be reminding you from the other end of life, "Didn't I tell you I was sick?" So at least go a little bit above that, that kind of humour. And if you're putting on something in Nora, what would you put on for her? You know? In what one sense it could be, she inspired me. I could say she, when I came here first of all, before she was at her house, she gave me a pot of jam. Pot of jam. Lovely touch, you see. And I knew then she told me four things about making jam and things like that. And I think on the second visit then she asked me, had I finished a pot of jam? Yes. You see. I don't think I'd have got a second pot if it, but of course I told her that I had. You see. But there might be still something in the one in the pot, but anyway. Well, I knew then if I said it wasn't finished, that I wouldn't be getting a second one and things like that. Anyway, at the moment I've got plenty of jam, so don't be worried. So I won't go for a shot anyway. But a rich, long life, an inspiration to many other people as well. So, as I said goodbye to today, you know, do it in a loving way. She will be taking her mail soon up to Havana. I remember it was the first mass at Dublin I came here. In the Havana a couple of years ago now, just before the COVID came on, she'll go that evening and call the evening for the mass itself. And I presume it was one of her last visits to the place. And her mortal remains will be taken up later there, where she herself prayed and often prayed as well to for other family members who passed before. Now my brothers and sisters will have the prayers of the faithful, so those who have them now, please come forward with them.
We pray for Nana in baptism. She was given the pledge of eternal life. May she now be admitted to the company of saints.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray in thanksgiving for all the blessings that came to so many people through the life of Nana. May she now receive the fullness of God's blessings in eternity.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Pray for the family and friends of Nana and all those who cared for her. May the Lord be their strength and consolation, and may Nana's spirit live on through all of us, Lord hear us.
We honour Mary, Mother of Jesus, by saying, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Heavenly Father, we send our prayers and petitions to you. We ask your testamental blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, the fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, the fruit of the vine, the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted with the God of the Almighty Father. Then the prayer of the gifts, as we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, we beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of this resurrection has dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us kneel now for the Eucharistic prayer. God indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks and broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you for this worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray the partake of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember our church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together Francis our Pope, Raymond our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Nora, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is enlightened with your Son and death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our other brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy, all we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coursed to eternal life, be praised and glorified through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And ye scream, ye shall not have from the moon or storm or no idea. Or not her, at our now, but there for dining, but all of the real, when you enter the hall and tell of when you enter the nav. On and on, lay poor, the true doing of smart and our beaker, or one need of the tone of fame, and diction of God, who would say a shame of all. Deliver us, God, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as with the blessed hope in the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ, with the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. this evening may your body and blood of Lord Jesus Christ not bring to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy before me, protection, mind and body, and a healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God, and behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter my roof, but I say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon her with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal grace unto her, O Lord, and perpetual light shine upon her with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Thank you. Now before we go separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her, may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully meet her again, when the love of Christ which conquers all things destroys even death itself. We will now bless the remains of the holy water, remind us of our baptism, and they will use the incense as well, remind us of our confirmation. Because so these sacraments, baptism and confirmation, these sacraments of initiation, as we call them, the late Nora became by adoption a sister to Jesus. afflictions. Saints of God, come to our aid. Hasten to meet our angel of the Lord. Receive her soul visit of the God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take it to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul visit of the Most High. Eternal rest granted to our Lord, and a perpetual life shall upon her. Receive her soul visit of the God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Nora, in the sure, certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us, listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurance of the faith, until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our sister forever. In peace then, let us take our sister to her place of rest. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And while Lazarus is no longer, may you find eternal rest. And with the great promise of the scriptures, you take with us. I am the resurrection life of the Lord. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Amen. Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, Lily, we say the words of thanks and appreciation for you.
I have a few people that I need to mention. First of all, I'd like to thank the doctors and the nurses for the care to go to on. We're thinking of my sister Adeline in New York and her family, my brother John in Cheltenham and his family. They are sorry that they can't be here with us, but we're thinking of them. Now, we as a family, we look back with fondness every day at the wonderful memories we have. We all have such different memories that we could share. All our lives, you were by our side to help us and guide us. We always felt safe with you and secure. We will always remember the wonderful dishes you would create, or the jams you would make, or when you made dozens and dozens of donuts, queen cakes, pies, etc. We also remember all the sewing you would do, repairing and creating beautiful garments for us. There was nothing she could not do. We will fondly remember the many fun times, like when she dressed up as a witch on Halloween and went down and climbed to the top of Cali Castle and was wailing off the top and convinced all the grandchildren that the witch came here every Halloween. Not to mention the endless games of 41. She would always say, we'd have one more. That one more went on forever. But above all, we will miss you and the wonderful personality you had. You lived your life with such kindness in your heart. You never ever saw badness in anybody. If somebody did something wrong, she would always say, sure they did their best. You always went out of your way to try to help everybody. And she fed half of Ballymackessy. Anyone who needed help got it. Mom had a great devotion to the Rosary and to the Blessed Virgin. At the Ballylongford Grotto was a very special place for Mom. We were always so proud that you were our wonderful mother. And you would be very dearly missed, Mom. We love you. Now, I have two people that need a special thank you. And that's my sister Nora and her husband, Ali. Mom wasn't able to live on her own for the last 2 years, and she went to live with Nora. Every time you go over to see Mom, I say, Mom, how are you? How would I be, she said, in the two great nurses that I have. I couldn't ask for any more. Nora and Ali, on behalf of me and all the family, we will never, ever be able to thank you enough. Thanks a million. Thank you, everybody.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Our sister Nora has gone to rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be united one day with our sister. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. And we read in such a scripture, "This is the will of my Father, said the Lord, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I shall raise it up on the last day." O God, by whose mercy the spirit of the departed find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it. As we bury here the body of our sister, deliver her soul from every bond of sin, that she may rejoice in you and with your saints forever. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Nora, and we commit her body to the ground. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Dear friends, in reverence let us pray to God, the source of all mercies. You raise the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Lord, you console the Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Nora, and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Comfort us now for the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
We pray for all who are buried in the cemetery, particularly in this grave. May their suffering be lessened. May their joy be increased. And may the light of glory shine on them, and may they rest in peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. God of holiness and power, I accept our prayers on behalf of your servant. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to her people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
By the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn for Nora, and accompany all of us in our time of need. The eternal rest granted to our Lord, and the perpetual light shone upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul, the soul of all the faithful departed, the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. As we lay her remains now to rest in this grave, we now pray Decatur's Rosary for her eternal repose, for all those who lie in this grave, in this particular grave, and for all the grieving family, the resurrection of Jesus from the dead. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Hail Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now that they are of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now that they are of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now that they are of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now that they are of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Mother of God, pray for sinners now that they are of our death. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Eternal rest granted to our Lord, perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her souls and all the souls of all the faithful of the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.